Actually, something for an execute here. At least smoke and a Molotov, usually an indication that something is up. And you can tell the bomb is outside of the A-bomb site. They're sort of setting up for something. I don't know if I wouldn't have rather that that Molotov was a smoke, but I'm interested to see how it'll play out. I feel like two smokes might have been a stronger approach if he wanted to execute on the A-bomb site.
What I wonder is the impact that Kassad will have on a map like Mirage, a very tactical map. A lot of options on T-side and CT-side. That's where perhaps Kassad, as the coach, can really get a chance to shine and influence the game here from Allsports, who are starting on the T-side. Guardian finds Nico to begin with, but Dennis will bring him back. He takes out Edward from short. And so we're into a 4-on-4 take on the A-side, and next finds one, but Flamey lurking and sandwiching, get right, only gets the one kill.
Well, Crisp coming up with two really good shots there. Seized, trying to see if he can stop them from crossing on over. It was just a 1-on-3, and he's looking for more. Gonna get the headshot seized, determined to close out this round. And Chris, he's one shot away, and there it is. Seized single-handedly taking out all three members of Allsports. 1-on-3 win for him. That's a big clutch to start off with.
Unreal. And also unreal, Chris continues to buy the Deagle in pistol rounds. Just saying, that's interesting. Definitely an interesting choice, considering sometimes you want to have more of like a spray and pray kind of gun. The Glock, that's the strength of it. You know, run and gun, just 20 bullets, and you just run at your opponents. Sticking with the Deagle, that could actually, hurt a little bit unless you're hitting your shots, right? And seized. He didn't get tagged until the very end, so.
I sort of wish we could almost pause and ask Mousesports what the idea was with that Molotov, because unlike on train where you could use it to sort of stop from someone from defusing, you technically could do that on the A-bomb side, but you have to be so precise. It's not as easy.
Look at this call from Na'Vi. If Mousesports go... Okay, so they go for the 4-spy, yes. But if they go for the YOLO onto B, three players are here from Na'Vi right now. This can get nuts. Na'Vi with this call. This is a hard counter to what Mousesports have in store for them. Molotovs are going to go sailing out. Seized is here. He's going to get a Molotov of his own down. And now it begins, but it's a straight running gun from Nico. Annihilate Seized. Nex is there to trade. And somehow Mousesports, they just crack right through.
What an incredible piece of timing there coming out. And Guardian going to be going down as well. Nico's stolen that M4 and he still has health to use it with. And Chris, fantastic shot on Flamey. Edward. He was on catwalk the whole time, but he couldn't really do anything. There's too many smokes raining in. Now he's in a 1-on-3, trying to see if he could get a bit closer, but he's going to walk into a bit of a trap, actually.
Unfortunately for him, Nico's going to have his back. Edward, as soon as he presses through this window, Nico can come in through kitchen. Speedy on the site, spots out Edward, and there you go, boom. Instant headshot coming in from Nico, and a 1-1 tie situation. Mousesports go for the 4-spy, the YOLO rush onto the B site, and it actually works, despite Na'Vi trying to set up to counter this initially.
Well, it's so ridiculous because you are right. They had everything set up for this one. If the Molotov had been out 2 seconds earlier, or if they just bought a little bit more time, but that they just were not ready for it, in spite of obviously having all the players in the right positions. So, great start for Mousesports.
Very quick short smoke going down here. Nico setting it up, and now, well, this allows for Mousesports to get out unmolested. Seized is still here, though, with that scout. He's going to be looking for the jump shots, but big nade right on top of him. Some bullets as well. He's dropped down to 10 HP. Doesn't even see anybody.
Bit of a shame. That scout could do a lot of damage in the middle, but he's going to be falling back all the way into CT spawn, in fact, while the rest of Na'Vi grouped up and stacked up in the B-bomb site, because why not? Might as well try and get something out of the round.
It's going to be interesting as if Edward can spot anybody moving up connector. If they do decide to commit to short, he's going to be ready for him. But if the call is given by C's that, hey, people are in connector, they're coming this way, Edward can also be a nuisance with the Deagle there. But it does look like Mousesports wants to eventually just charge up short, get in Edward's face. Nico there to open things up with that M4A1.
Oh, that Molotov in the corner. Seuss trying to make it out, but Speedy going to get the kill on him. And Nico charging through, so once again, Na'Vi, they're in the right bomb site. They have the stack going on there, but Mousesports just overwhelming them. And Seized looks like he's going to be able to save the scout unless they delay the plant and go hunt for him.
Don't think that there shouldn't be a reason for it, right? At this point, guys, just you have all of the points covered. Get the bomb plant down and just start the countdown. And there really isn't any reason for you to risk any of the rifles that you've picked up hunting down a single solitary scout. You know that Na'Vi are going to be hard ecoing in the next round. You know that now they've force spawned. So their economy is going to be in the dumps. I mean, they're going to send out a single man, and that's Chris J, and he's got the UMP. So if you sack an SMG searching for it, that's not the end of the world. Just don't risk the AKs or the M4.
Yeah, see how that's going to work out for Chris. See, he's having a really hard time here. Even with the pistol, it's not so easy. Just letting him pass, which might be a better option. Remember, Cease doesn't know if there's someone else right behind Chris. So even if he kills Chris, there could be three other people right there to take him out. So not getting the shot in is actually a much better option. Smart play from Cease.
Yeah, very smart. And holding on to the scout as well, much better than the gun that he would have had that he would have picked up from Chris. And that's probably what he noticed as well. He's like, well, he doesn't have an AK. He doesn't have a Galil. So might as well hold on to the scout, see if I can't get something done in the next round. He saves his Kevlar as well. So not the best start here for Na'Vi, considering how the pistol went. I mean, the pistol was still a clutch situation, so seized off to a strong start. But Milesport's coming right back into it. 2-1 lead for them now. Now they have all of the nades, and it looks like they just want to set up for a full execute onto the A site. Once again, Starix, though, he is getting the reads correct as far as positioning his troops. Like, he's got all five players now stacked up on this A site. If Milesport do go for the smoke execute, I mean, he's given Na'Vi the best chance possible to do some damage.
Yeah, it's quite incredible. It's not normally this easy to try and guess where the terrorist side is coming for, and this time it's working out a little bit better for Na'Vi. Right now trading 2 for 2. Dennis coming in with a very good double kill. They're going to try and see if they can check sandwich, and they will be successful. Third kill coming in for Dennis, leaving Seuss alone, trying to get one more shot in. Another bullet would have taken out next, but it will be a quad kill for Dennis. And I mean, again, Na'Vi, they're in the right position. They don't get as much out of it as you maybe would have thought they could.
No, that seemed like Zeus could have actually done a lot more. Given if he had a P250 there instead of the P2K, wouldn't have taken him so long. He would have got that third kill. And that would have been all right for Na'Vi, considering the hard eco scenario that they were in. Would have been fine. They would have gotten three kills out of a hard eco. Pretty solid. Especially given the fact that, I mean, Nico's got to be frustrated. I mean, he got rushed down an apartment right as he pulls out a nade. Doesn't get any worse than that. But now we have the buy round coming in here for Na'Vi. After that round of eco, they're going up to the four rifles. Guardian manages economy well enough to afford the AWP. And Milesport, of course, full bought everything. So this is it for Na'Vi. Can they actually make it happen for themselves here and get control back in this first half, or are Milesport going to be set up to just run away with it?
This is a map that does favor the CT side. So if Milesport could bring this round home, suddenly they will be in a very strong position. If Na'Vi win this round and it sort of resets a little bit, and it'll be hard to say who's going to win it. They're going to try and get the boost in here to look on the catwalk. Very good idea. You can actually sit on the edge there, but it's probably a pixel walk, so might not be a good idea. Edward going to be burned to a crisp, and next picking up a kill on Sue. Still a 3-on-4 here. Na'Vi desperately need this round.
Now they've got the AK, but sees with the flank from B Halls, and he's going to drop the bomb carrier as well. Nico and Spitty dead, and now a man advantage for Na'Vi. They do know that Nex is pushed down from Pit and seized, and Nex both coming up with kills. Actually, Dennis, rather, drops seized. And somehow now it's Guardian alone, 1v2. He's got the op, but he's not going to find the shot fast enough. Nex, instant headshot. Guardian clearly annoyed with that.
For good reason. They had just saved a lot to just try and get all the rifles into that round. And they can't make it work. Now instead, it's a double up setup for Milesport. And again, Na'Vi without any money to buy him. This is a very tricky situation to be in if you're on the CT side.
More curious about whether or not that they're... I mean, are Na'Vi going to continue with the pressure here? Let's see. Zeus taking his time. He's sitting back in CT spawn. Hasn't bought anything. He's just taking a drink of water?
Yeah. Relaxing.
Oh, he's taking off his hoodie. Okay.
No pressure.
No pressure. Just, you know, obviously a bit too warm, right? It's hot Lana for a reason.
It's been better, though, I feel like, than it was a couple of weeks ago.
It isn't as bad as I thought it would be, right? It was more humid 2 weeks ago, at least.
Yeah, definitely.
But apparently, like, there was a heat wave, so we dodged the heat wave, right, Anders?
Success.
As far as I'm concerned, winning.
I guess what's frustrating right now for me watching Na'Vi play is how passive they're playing on the CT side. This is a map that lends itself, and we keep saying this every single time, because it continues to be true. It lends itself so well to CT side aggression. I mean, Cease is pushed up here, but that doesn't really matter at this point in time, because this is not a round that Na'Vi could do a lot in. But why haven't we seen any attempts at mid-pushes or anything like that? It seems like they're very, very defensive. And Milesport have been landing great grenades all over the place. The Molotovs seem to be on point. Flashbangs seem to be on point, so as long as they're being very passive, Milesport kind of know how to deal with that.
What I'm looking for now is Guardian in the next round. When he gets that off, is he going to take it into mid-window, or is he going to play passive on the A site? I will say Zeus gonna get overwhelmed. Dennis once again takes point, charges onto the site. Edward is in a bit of a clever corner though, so we'll see if that works out for him. Incendiary is going all over the place, and there we go. Edward starting it off. Will take the shots at next, but he gets completely shut down and seized. Well, he's pushed all the way through T-spawn into mid. Not gonna find anybody lurking either, so he just can't catch a break. Right now, he's just like, please, let me kill someone and save the AK.
If you look at it, almost all of the positions as they get into the bomb site are gonna be Molotoved out. So it's great having a stack. It's just the problem is no one's gonna be able to stand still. So it's that should be a sign to Na'Vi that they've done some research about sports on just on throwing Molotovs on this map. It seems to be the part of the key right now for Mousesports.
It's really surprising. I mean, look at this right now. Flamey, Zeus. These guys, Flamey in particular, he was mentioned at mentioned by the desk, picked out basically at the beginning of this when you're looking at key factors here for Na'Vi and their success recently is that Flamey is a big part of that. That 1-2 combination punch between him and Guardian. Him with the rifle, Guardian with the op. And Guardian, speaking of which, he will have his AWP. Seized also going to the double op, so, I mean, Seized has got his AWP. He'll play passive on that, actually depends. Should be playing passive on the B site with it. But the question is whether Guardian actually decides to go straight towards mid, and it doesn't look like it right now. He's kind of geared up to go towards A, so does he play aggressive mid from connector? No. What is this? A bit interested as to why you would want to have such a versatile opper play more of a turret role than anything.
Yeah, I mean, Edward is in the middle. Flamey's there as well. Edward is a little bit alone. That is a good start for Guardian here. We'll pick up a kill on Dennis at least, but instant refrag coming through. There's no one there to help out Edward. That kill was always going to be sort of an all or nothing for Edward because there was no one there to back him up either. Nex jumping across, quick to look over the smoke, see if he can catch anyone here. And actually just going to re-smoke it so they could get that bomb pound down. Nico is sneaking into the middle, and you can see he's a bit worried right now that someone might be flanking, but as long as they don't have the bomb plant, at least now we have some time to get into a position for a retake right now. Nyx going down to Zeus, and with the bomb plant home, still a chance that Mousepaw could steal this away. Guardian dying, and what a shot coming out from Chris. Flamey out of the game, and now it's just seized.
That second shot is so dirty.
How does that even work? That actually looked really weird.
He was so fast. Okay, then. And I mean, this is out of control now. Mousesports, 6 rounds. 4 of them start the round with 10k plus money. Like, that is a sick bank to work with right now if you're Mousesports. But that second kill, thing of beauty from Chris, that's some flawless movement, basically, that allows him to reset his aim. And it's just perfectly timed. Boom, pulls the trigger. 6 kills, 3 deaths so far. Solid ADR. And while Na'Vi know that they're so far behind, they have to go for the force. And Nico, he's in a bit of a trouble. Na'Vi, they're trying to go aggressive pit, but they don't decide to push on it.
Well, I'm glad that they're doing that at least. It is time for it. Like, they've been playing passively so much here. And I think this is sort of a mental thing, I think, because when you start off being behind and then you save a couple of rounds, you can finally buy rifles. The one thing you feel like, sort of intuitively, you think, well, we can't just throw these away by pushing somewhere, you know? We got to really be careful and sort of save them and guard them. And I think they're playing way too timidly right now. They got to step it up. No more respect and no more passive play.
I'm wondering if they aren't overthinking things with how things went against Echo Fox earlier on Dust2, where they weren't able to get things under control. They got raffle stomped basically on that map. Well, not raffle stomped. I mean, they did manage to fight back to double digits at the end, but first half was pretty brutal. And that was after Na'Vi showed a total lack of respect in the first map, right? So
yeah. Well, I mean, I'm not sure. I think it's just someone needs to make the call. And right now, I mean, Starix obviously in the game with them, so he just hasn't seen that opening yet. Flash is coming out, trying to see if they can make their way in. Zeus in the corner with the FAMAS, but again, just flashed long enough for them to get into position, and he was only ever going to trade one for one in that position. Edward, good shot on him, but he doesn't realize Dennis is going to be there as well. Mousesports is playing these executes so well, and Seized is here, obviously looking for the cancel, but no! Going to be taken out by Dennis. You could tell that he wanted that so badly. Guardian charging it with the UMP, picks up one, sprays, and doesn't connect, and now all on Flamey.
There's Chris J, and Chris J has now got the angle to support his teammate. Dennis manages to sneak his way back to the site. Flamey missed a bit of an opportunity there to get the punish, and Dennis instead will come and find him.
Quad kill.
Yeah, quad kill for Dennis. He's waking up. It's not just on anti-eco rounds that he's doing damage. And that's a 7-1 scoreline. Mouse Sports, they're just taking off. So far in the lead now versus a Na'Vi who are just constantly looking for four spies at this point. They're like, we need to get rounds on the board here.
I've got to say, though, I am on Thorin's side because, I mean, I do think Na'Vi should be one of the best teams in the world, and for a long time has been one of the best teams in the world at this map, but the CT sign for them is absolutely miserable. They seem sort of shell-shocked. They seem to be have like no motivation and no real... They don't take any initiative at all.
Finally, Guardian's in mid. And he's holding aggressive as well towards top.
And Flamey's pushing up.
Yeah, fine. Like that's what I'm looking for, right? Because when they're at their most lethal, their most dangerous, is when Guardian was just dominating mid. No team could get control of it because he was just so good at being this aggressive player there, looking for picks. Now it's going to be the one-for-one trade. Guardian is able to trade, take Chris J, but Dennis is instantly there to trade back and take out Zeus. And now it's a man advantage here for Mousesports, just pressing onto the A site.
Ooh, that's a good flashbang there. Gonna put Guardian out for a couple of seconds. Bomb. Not quite being planted, it looked like they wanted to, and Guardian, he's so anxious to get up there, but the Molotov actually gonna take him out. Speedy with the kill, C's coming in with one, and the double! Nex and Dennis both falling victim to that one. But with the bomb plant here, and the limited equipment on Na'Vi's side, how did they make this happen?
Now he's actually got a gun to work with, so that's a positive, that's a plus, it's an AWP as well. And he sees the lurk coming in, Nico though, free kill for him, takes out Edward, and now Seize knows that he has an opponent at his back, and well, the bomb is planted for the man in mid as well, so he needs to battle his way out of here at this point to try and save this gun. No kit, he seems to have an idea that Speedy's waiting for him in pit. There's the shot, and now Seize has an exit point, he can actually get out of here to save the gun. Best case scenario for him. But Nico, with that one kill, basically just seals it up. And Mousesports, 8 rounds on the board now versus Na'Vi, who only have the single one. And Seez seems to be the only one really doing anything right now for Na'Vi.
Yeah, 9 kills on him, but 13 on Dennis, who's sort of taken off on this map. 8-1. I mean, where is this coming from? Think about what a strong map this is for the Na'Vi team, although admittedly, sort of a lot of the iterations of Mousesports have also been quite good on this map, so historically speaking, it's not as if though it's impossible. I just think what's frustrating is the lack of initiative for Na'Vi, but I think this must be a tactical timeout for Na'Vi.
Must be a tactical pause, yeah. I mean, right now, and the joke to be made is, you know, we aren't even in the finals, man. Na'Vi. You're supposed to be just dominating, you know? This is a team that, unlike Astralis, who seem to struggle or have struggled in the past, right, getting past the semifinals, Na'Vi, they consistently get to the finals and then aren't able to close it out.
And well, so, I mean, on top of that, they tied it with Echo Fox earlier, right? So now things are looking really interesting. If they end up losing this map, then what's going to happen to this group? Because of all the teams here, the one team you think, they're just... through to the to Friday to play on TBS. You think that would be Na'Vi, right?
Yeah. No, that's. I mean, they are pretty much like the top dominant force in this group, and maybe coming into it, that's what they were expecting. They just aren't able to just shut that down. Stark's doing a lot of talking right now.
Yeah, you could tell. Just got the gestures in. Got everything going on right now.
This is where I wonder if he's still got control of the team or not. There was some frustration. I mean, he was one of the first coaches to go full in-game leader, and I mean, he's experienced it all basically. You know, where he has to have that argument sometimes with his players to get them to listen to him, and he's been one of the coaches that's spoken about, you know, difficulties with authority just basically because, you know, he doesn't have a whip. He doesn't really have any full control over the team. They just have to basically respect what he has to say and do it, right? But you're talking about some very headstrong players sometimes, so. Right now, Starix, there's a lot riding on him to figure out a solution here.
Yeah, and I mean, I don't know if this is particularly the problem. It could be any number of things, I suppose. But for one thing, Zeus, for the longest time, was the leader of this team, right? Mm-hmm. They're going all the way back to 1.6. So you know, you could imagine a world in which, if things start to go south, then maybe Zeus would be the guy to say, let me try and make some calls again, you know? And when it's working, maybe that's fine. But right now, it's a little bit questionable here. 8-1 favoring Mousesports. We're moving into the 10th round. There is an AWP and Guardian that they managed to save that was seized making it out in that last round. Yeah, we talked about the hero orb earlier. They need it.
Yeah, he's going aggressive again. I like it. Chris J is going to find the kill on Zeus, though. That was B Halls over on the B site. Now Guardian, he's just going aggressive mid, looking for some kind of pick, anything to bring it back here. Nico, far too wise for that, has already backed off. And Nico's now got the edge of that angle. He's got that angle. There's a shoulder peek. Man, Nico's so aware. Doesn't get caught off guard. Just playing it safe. Realizes that there is the chance that Guardian is up there top mid. He actually baits out the shot, gets confirmation.
Yeah, it's interesting because I feel like to the newcomer, that what we just saw doesn't seem like that interesting, you know? So what, they dodged each other in middle and one guy saw an elbow and failed the shot, you know? But actually, it is quite interesting because it does show that, like, the level of intuition on either player, right? Either one of them could have made a big mistake, and Guardian pushing up after he hears the shot coming out through the smoke is also just, like, very clever. He heard that and thought, this is probably just the last two shot before he runs back. And it was, you know? So both players just reading it very well. That's interesting.
Oh, sick plays, but Mousesports now with the man advantage and the gear. They're going to be heading over. Guardian, did he actually successfully body block that? I think that's what he was trying to do. It's not going to happen. Incendiary's all over the place, but point blank. Hello, Spitty. Good night, Spitty. Guardian drops him.
Still in the bomb site, but only for a second. And next will take him out and seized. Good little flank coming in, but I don't think it'll make a big difference. Charging on in, trying to see if he can deny the plant. Gonna pick up the one. Oh, what? Seized, and another one coming through. Looking for the last of the sequence, but Nico gonna shut them down with a triple of his own. What a magnificent sequence here from Seized.
Unbelievable. That CZ, that is so much pressure as well. You've only got the 12 bullets in there. You're running and gunning with it, point blank. Unreal. Look at this. The last bullet as well. And then to pick out Chris J is, I mean, just what a magnificent play. He even had Nico dead to rights as well. Split second more, he might have been able to get that kill and go for the massive quad kill clutch.
That would have been one of the most impressive quads for quite a while, actually. Even the triple is quite good, but tragically for Na'Vi, it's not going to be enough right now. They need more. 9-1 being the scoreline. Double up setup is what they've got going on. Again, very passive hold in the middle. They are allowing Mousesports, if they want to get some control in here, although Edward is trying to challenge it a little bit. I like the fact that C has moved up so far, and that's a good trade here. Guardian picking up Speedy as well, and the follow-up on Nyx, and finally it seems something is working.
Oh, Chris J misses the shot. He had him dead to rights as well. Had that angle, and now Zeus is able to take out Nico. It is all on Chris, and he's going to fall to Guardian. Triple kill for Guardian, playing from CT. And that's just the ticket for Na'Vi. That's exactly what they needed. A big performance, you know, back-to-back big performances, basically. Seized in the round before that to get his teammates fired up, and now Guardian just locked things down. Very solid work coming through. Mousesports finally having to tap into that bank. Losing four players in the round before, now losing the round. A lot of them were starting pretty high up there. But Nico, for example, literally just spent $9,000 in this round just getting everybody equipped. So, Mousesports, not a whole lot left in the tank.
This time we have Seuss in the window. Edward pushing up a little bit here. Good grenade going to be raining in. He guesses the right angle and Speedy runs right into that HE. A good little setup there, you know, one Molotov to force them out and then hope that you guess that they're going to be running out on the right side there. So, I like that much.
That's always a nasty boost as well. Looking really, yep, it pays off. Zeus walks right into it. Up on A, the call coming in from Chris J, communicating. But Edward always hanging around on short somewhere. And this time, ladder room. Smoke goes off to block him, so he's not going to really be able to get too much, but he might be getting some audio information, and that's also going to be key. Guardian, looking into mid, picks off Chris J.
Bit of a smoke. Great shot from Dennis. He's really coming alive on this map. It's so interesting how some maps just sort of make some players almost automatically play better. Next to take out Flamey and Guardian and sees two AWPs left. It will be enough here. It's a 2-on-2. Once the bomb goes down, it could get a bit tricky with these orbs. And actually sees to switch it out for an AK. That might be a very good idea. A lot of Molotovs raining out here. Still 30 seconds. Where is that bomb plant going to come from? It's going to be Speedy, in fact, and they're just going to go straight for it.
Just going to stick it. Guardian dodges the HE, though. Next holding close. Now, Speedy, it's all about him baiting. He needs to just try and draw attention, set it up for Nex, who's going to get the advantage, the drop on his on the aggressors, basically. There you go. Nex lights one up, but he's not actually going to be able to get the kill, and he falls to Guardian. Guardian with two kills in the retake shuts him down, but for a second there, it looked like Nex was able to pick off Seized. How did he not get that kill?
I don't think we'll ever get a good answer to that. I think that should have absolutely been a shot. Big mistake, damn. Good couple of kills coming in from Guardian, though. But yeah, if Nyx gets the shot, then probably the round is over, right?
Because then Speedy is there to catch out Guardian. If Guardian's trying to react and get the trade kill onto Nyx, Speedy is there to peek and pick off Guardian. Things pan out completely differently, but what a retake. Na'Vi just battling back here. Three rounds on the board for them, 9 for Mousesports. So it's still a terrific scoreline for Mousesports, no matter how you cut it, but Na'Vi's still showing that they have some fight in them. Guardian and Seized doing work. The smoke goes down to block off Guardian, just trying to get lucky with the timing there with the shot. Not going to happen. And Mousesports once again taking over mid.
Yeah, and once again, it seems being allowed to do that. I think more than I would like it to be. Edward with a good shot coming through. Could have been a double, and it will be, in fact. Has to reload, obviously, at some point. There's still a 3v4 right now, as Speedy does pick up a kill on Guardian there. Seemed a bit silly, really.
Solid work, absolutely. Now Speedy, good use of the map architecture to look over that smoke. Has to realize that Edward's holding close, though. That bait from Zeus, but there's a flash! Speedy takes out Edward for free! Zeus, and it's actually Flamey. Zeus has fallen back. But Flamey holding close. We're into a 3-on-3 now. Mousesports looking to collapse onto this B side. Eventually, Flamey right around the corner gets him to line up. Speedy actually gets the kill on Dennis as well. But we're into the 2-on-2.
Hashtag worth, you know? That's a trade that you're willing to make to bring it into a 2-on-2. 40 seconds here. If they can just get in and get the bomb down here, that would break Na'Vi so badly. They've only won 2 rounds in a row here, and they've been close rounds, so CT side, they got to keep fighting here. Problem is Speedy's kind of got the bomb trapped in the middle here. Oh, Seized, he misses the flick. No scope. Not going to connect. How does that happen? Seized, he's been solid. But right now, Speedy's got a quad kill. One more for the ace, and a single bullet would do it as well. Zeus making his way in through the window. We need Speedy to do this, obviously, and there it is, the ace against Na'Vi. Speedy, heavily criticized all throughout the day, and I don't think in the era either he hasn't been playing that well. But this is a pretty good round. That's actually 6 kills in 1 round.
Right? I was about to say. He actually gets 6 of them. That's all right. It works sometimes. And he just decided to take over. Well, that's... I mean, you can see the frustration in Seized because he just goes for, like, the full-on double facepalm there at the end of that round. He knows he was so close to being able to just lock that down for his team. Instead, it's Mousesports double digits now. 10 rounds for them, 3 for Na'Vi. And while it is going to be Guardian once again with the hero op, a scout picked up on Seized, pistols on the rest of them. And while Mousesports, of course, they have the full buy. They have everything they need. And once again, going straight into mid. They've been so consistently good with this, Mousesports. Getting into mid, getting control of it.
Especially because Na'Vi aren't even challenging them nearly at all. Good shot there from Guardian, and actually Edward creeping around in underpass, getting a bit of damage here before he goes down to Dennis. Hero, scout, hero, ult. Not going to be any kind of heroics coming out of Flamey. Ends up dropping to Nico.
Nico channeling his inner NA player, man. Just scrims through that smoke. What was that? And now Guardian, he will get the pick on Dennis. Man advantage now for Na'Vi. But the bomb is making its way towards that B site. Man holding there is Seized, and he's been so good. So we'll see if he can deliver here once again. Nade's going down to try and clear out some angles here, but Seized not too worried about it. Doesn't have Kevlar, though, so this could get a little tricky if he gets into a big spray fight, but he will get the drop on Spitty, and he knows that Nex is holding close to bench. Will hunt him down, but not find the kill. Still, 1v2. His teammates should be able to get the job done from here.
Yeah, they should. They even have armor. They have pretty much everything going for them right now, and Nex out in the open, no bomb plant. Great headshot, though, coming through. Zeus going to be going down. Guardian, one-on-one here, 24 seconds. Bit of a grenade coming through. Nyx peeking into kitchen. A little bit worried right now that Guardian may have switched his position a lot. He does see the gun barrel there, and it's going to be falling back. I think he really wants to take the fight, and he doesn't want to try and put the bomb down, but eventually he's going to have to, and that allows Guardian to get just a bit closer here. 7 seconds, jumping through the window. Nyx putting the bomb down, going to be peeking right in front of him. Guardian not clicking the mouse yet, and there it is. He's gonna pick up the shot. Triple kill for him. If we see that from Guardian's point of view, I guarantee you there's gonna be at least twice there where he has the shoulder that he could see and he doesn't take the shot. And the problem is that if he does and fails, he's out of the round. So that's so hard to do. It's, you gotta have so much confidence and what we call trigger discipline to not take those shots. Just look at it here. There's the first chance. Does see it, doesn't take the shot, and there's the second one. Very impressive.
Yeah, that scope sound, that scope coming in, basically, that's what gives it away for Nex. Because I was wondering if Nex had actually spotted Guardian's shoulder there, if somebody had called it out from his teammates, but it's actually the scoping sound that caused Nex to freak out and realize where Guardian was coming from. Just wild play. That's the kind of 1v1 that we want, just all mind games. And well, we're into the 15th round now of the first half. 4 rounds on the board for Na'Vi, 10 for Mousesports. Well, it's a bit of a force buy coming out from Mousesports, actually. Their bank, not that good. Seize, though, going to be able to get the free kill. Falls back, gets the shot onto Nex before he gets blinded. Goes back for more. There's the third, and he nearly gets the fourth.
Wow. Quad kill in the 15th round here. Seized. It seems like he's sort of stolen Guardian's mojo at this point in time. This is the sort of stuff that we're used to seeing out of Guardian. Very impressive.
Just picturing, like, what? So, Guardian, we haven't seen him in a while, right? How did he heal up? He was cryogenically frozen, seized, went back in time.
Something like that. I mean, he is from Russia. Have you ever played Red Alert with the Yuri character? You know, he can sort of take over other players, like other tanks. I don't know. He is top ranking anyway. Very, very impressive. As we get into the second half, we'll see if Mousesports can close out this incredible match that they started. Welcome back, everybody. We do have the second half coming up here between Mousesports and Na'Vi, and honestly, just a great performance from Mousesports. The only one pretty much throughout all that half that really did anything was Seized on the Na'Vi side. Very impressive stuff from him.
Guardian woke up a little bit at the end.
Yeah, a little bit.
He was just... I don't think that Na'Vi really made the adjustments necessary at the beginning of that half. By the time that they did, it was too late into it, right? Oh, we have to actually put up a fight mid?
Yeah.
On Mirage, SCT, what's that about, right? And they never really seemed to want to do that versus Mousesports. Mousesports were allowed to run free reign.
Yeah, and it seemed like Seize always showed, like, he showed up to try and sort of salvage the situation, right? Mm-hmm. But whenever they showed up at the B-bomb site, things were pretty good for Seize. I mean, look at the stuff at the end here. Just an incredible quad kill that he managed to put out.
Nearly picked up that last one there, but he gets it on the follow-up. Yeah, Seize is also just a very confident offer, all-around player. Doesn't get as much attention. I mean, mainly due to the fact that you have Flamie and Guardian on the team. Two very heavy hitters, but Seize, a man you can count on. And while he's got 19 kills, 8, that's 121 ADR. So really, I mean, despite being so far behind...
Yeah, I mean, it says a lot, doesn't it, that they only have half the rounds that Mousesports do, and yet he's... top fragging by 4 kills ahead of Dennis, who's the top fragger on Mousesports. So, bit of an individual performance coming out of Seize. And as you pointed out, Guardian did sort of wake up at the end. So we'll see if that can continue. Certainly going to need to do that unless they're going to give up this map here. 10-5. This is a CT-sided map. I feel like Mousesports are going to be feeling very good about themselves.
Well, the rush begins straight out onto the B site. The call is going to come in from Nex, and well, a headshot helps, that's for sure. He's still alive as well. 6 bullets, looking for the midair shot, not going to get it. It's Chris J instead, and Nico gets into the fight. What is this? Mousesports just pummeling Na'Vi. Guardian trying to make something happen here, but he's stuck behind the bench in a 1v5, and Chris, a triple kill for him in the pistol, just completely shutting Na'Vi down.
Yeah, they sort of almost let them into the bomb site, and by the time they got there, they were just so ready for it. That's incredible. And that first headshot from Nyx, you see how much Na'Vi slowed down behind it? Chris, really, really. He did not even stop for that kill. That was an actual drive-by. 11 to 5. And we have 5 deagles being picked up by Na'Vi. Whatever else happens, I'm a big fan of this play.
Yeah, I mean, mainly because Guardian can also do some pretty good damage. Flamey with the Deeg. Going to be looking for Dennis, who's going to be holding up close. Chris J is going to draw the attention. The shots go out. Surprise, surprise. Dennis is holding close, and now he gets a free Deagle. Awesome. But in the meantime, Na'Vi do manage to get a couple players out here to mid. So let's see if they can actually make something of this.
3 versus 5 at the moment. And the investment right now for Na'Vi not paying off at all. They're getting really nothing back from everything that they put into this round. And because they're so far behind, they needed to. You know, they needed to get 2, 3, 4 kills in a round like this, if not win it. Guardian, he's got the bomb. And I guess it's sort of a comfortable little room here. There's not much entertainment, but maybe they'll leave him alone if he just hides there for a long time.
Or do 94 damage to him in one shot. Okay, then.
Quad kill for Nico. Gonna make it 12 rounds for Mousesports. It's not really been much of a Nico show. He's been keeping up. It's actually, he is top fragging now. He's just overtaken it with that quad kill. But apart from that, Dennis and Nex, I think, have been like the two main impact players. And that's a scary thought. Like, if it's only now that Nico's gonna start to show up, what does that mean for Na'Vi?
Speaking of showing up, where is Flamey? He's sitting on 3 kills. We're going into the 18th round,
right.
And a key player for Na'Vi. It's just not having any impact whatsoever. Zeus as well, I mean, between the two of them right now, they are just really, they really need to step up. They need to figure out what's going on and what's going wrong here because, you know, Na'Vi rely heavily on Flamey to get those kills. But now it's, once again, going to be Na'Vi trying to get this bomb down, basically. And it's straight YOLO rush out onto the A site. Dennis is there to pick off Edward as it goes down. Guardian will succeed in getting the bomb plant. And well, there you go. Job well done. Success.
Yeah, I mean, some measure of success. I would say they need much more success, Samla. I mean, you know, just piles of success, essentially.
It's like, you know, the journey starts with a single bomb plant, right? You get the bomb plant, and then
I don't know what kind
step.
Of journeys you go on. yeah.
It's the first step. You know, they got the bomb plant, now they get the bonus money. Now they get everybody to be able to buy up. AWP on Guardian. Might not be, he wouldn't have been able to afford it otherwise. Oh, no, he would have just barely had enough for the AWP glass cannon. But I mean, it's like that $800 made a big difference. Now they have quite a few nades here for Na'Vi to work with. So they could go for a straight execute if they want. But at least at the beginning now, it looks like 3 players to top mid. And they're expecting some kind of aggression. Look at that, Guardian. It's like flashes, everything actually going up here, expecting some kind of push coming up from Mousesports.
Mousesports, on the other hand, they've got Dennis real close to the ramp here. So that's fine that they don't have mid control if they're going to try and take control somewhere else on the map. I'm all right with that. And they do flash their way in. Flamey does actually get flashed. A bit of a jump over there. Nico spotting over the smoke. Very smart play. Just remembers the angle and sprays down Edward.
That's so brutal. If you're Edward, you're just like, where? How? What happened? And then no chance to actually get the trade frag either because Nico's so quick to get back around the corner. There's the flash. Nico going for more. Sprays down seized. And the flash, I mean, that is the perfect setup. $200 investment. Boom, another kill. And now Mousesports, a 2-man advantage.
3 versus 5 right now. And this could almost be game here if Mousesports take this round away. Bomb is in the middle. Guardian sees a shoulder, and that's all he needed. Quick reactions.
Whoa, that's awkward.
Oh, quick trade. I mean, good job on Dennis at least being able to refrag that kill there, but Susan, Guardian, 2 versus 3, 30 seconds left. They need to get into a bombsite. They need to do it right now. Dennis is even in a great position if they're going to go for the A bombsite. If they go into B, I think things are going to get even worse for Na'Vi. Speedy on this corner, and Nyx in kitchen. Jump coming through, and actually Speedy trying to shoot both players at the same time, maybe not ideal. Nyx is here with the MP9, 10 seconds. Where is that bomb plant? It's not going to happen. The MP9 just too much to handle. Steals the AWP. Good round for Nyx.
Unbelievable. And here I was thinking, well, Nyx, yeah, but you know, if they push up short, he has an MP9. No, he just plays it safe until they actually get on the site where he can be lethal with that SMG. Up close and personal, that's what it's all about. What a spray. And while Mouse Sports right now, I mean, what is happening here? Na'Vi, they're two rounds away from getting bodied on the first map versus Mouse Sports on Mirage as well, which should be Na'Vi's playground. 14-5 though, Mouse Sports well in the lead, and it's a force buy from Na'Vi, not playing for overtime. They want to win it. They need to get this round locked. And let's see, I mean, it's going to be the straight rush out onto the A side at this point. Couple nades to support.
Dennis with one, sprays furiously, and that spray definitely was not very effective. Guardian getting the better of him this time. Nico coming in, picks up one, but he can't actually transfer it onto the next player there. So still a 3-on-3. A little bit sloppy play coming out of Mouse Sports.
This is getting just a little ugly. C is just going to have to just show up, do a lot of damage here, basically, because he is the one who's going for the lurk. Both players for Mouse Sports on the A site playing from CT. And with a minute left on this clock, Na'Vi realizing, wait a second, we don't actually have to commit to the A site if we don't want to. And it's only just now that it's dawning on Nex. He's starting to work his way back towards that B site. Mouse Sports, this has taken long enough for them to realize there are options. And C is so clever with his positioning. He hears him running by.
Yeah.
So now they know at least one player is there for Mouse Sports on that B site.
There is a bit of an issue in the fact that Nex has both Molotov and Smoke, and now that Seized is gone, then means a big part of that flank is out of it. And Nex is saving this Molotov. It's going to be so frustrating for Na'Vi, especially if he puts it down where the default plant is, because then they probably won't have a lot of time to really do anything. We'll see. Sue's going to be first man in. Is he going to see them walking by? He does, and there's the straight Molotov onto the plant. Seuss will be taking him out, so that's actually a bit of a shame. That was such a good defense put up by Nex, but the bomb will be going down in 10 seconds. Well, 10 seconds on the clock here, and a 2-on-2, and Speedy is miles away.
Yeah, he was so far away, I'm actually quite surprised. Chris J still patiently holding that angle, hoping that somebody's going to make the mistake of peeking into him. But it looks like Mouse Sports, they want to get both players stacked up going in together. A bit of time is ticked off this clock, though, so they're going to start feeling the pressure. Both of them have kits, so they have a little bit of extra time to work with. Nice flash coordination. Try and create some space, but Zeus is going to find the one kill. Chris J just charging in, looking for the shot on the man short. Not going to happen. Well played there with the crossfire from Na'Vi, and it works. The force buy, they actually managed to keep Mouse Sports from getting onto map point.
There were so many things in that round that were just so silly. I mean, like, how does Nex not buy more time once he puts out the Molotov? It seems like he could have been there all day almost. Also, why was Speedy though so far away? I mean, the Nex went down, and then even then it seemed like Speedy was not convinced that it was going to be a B hit. So, very weird round coming out, but 14-6. 10 rounds is what Na'Vi need basically in a row. Just 10 flawless rounds here.
Nico, just putting a little bit of a greeting out there for Edward. Few bullets through the smoke, Edward dropped down to 74 HP. But apart from that, Na'Vi continued to look to get that control on mid. Oh, the incendiary gonna force his hand. He has to charge forward. He's wondering where did that actually come from.
A little bit frustrating. I like this play from Dennis though. Look how aggressive he's being up at apartments right now. Pushing forward and getting information, if nothing else, about where Na'Vi aren't playing right now. Could go into some sort of a decision on where they rotate in.
Awkward positioning for Chris, though. Yeah, he is falling back to close that off, so he's gonna be focused on pit. Count on Dennis. Well, between the both of them, actually, focusing on A for now. But this is a rotation. At least it looks like initially Dennis is going to be changing it up. He might be getting closer towards that B site, where currently three players are stacked up for Mouse Sports. And it looks like Na'Vi, 45 seconds left on this clock, they want to push onto the B site.
Look at Speedy, close with the FAMAS. This is actually a very hard position to get many kills from with this kind of a rifle. Almost like you need an auto shotgun or something like that to make it work. Gun barrel gonna be showing, and Guardian missing a kill. Good shot from Speedy. Now he could just buy a lot of time. They only have 29 seconds, but he's gonna peek a little bit early maybe. Flamey will take him out, and now next there to follow it up. Nico as well, great job. And that's the kind of defense they needed. The bomb is up in the hallways as well and seized. Nothing that he could do at this point in time to save the Galil. Nothing else is gonna be working. 15-6 here, map point for Mouse Sports.
Fantastic work. And Nex, okay, maybe he fluffed it a little bit on the last round on the B site when he was holding solo with the Molotov, but this round was very nice of him. I mean, spots out the man on short, changes up his angle so he doesn't get punished from B apartments. He knows because his teammate just died up there that he's only got that half second to work with before he's vulnerable. So just really solid work there from Nex. And I mean, an excellent call. If it's Nico or Kassad or somebody basically going off some info, having the three players on that B site, Na'Vi just walked right into the trap. And Chris, midair, drops Edwards, spots Guardian getting behind the box as well. He gets tagged, so he knows that Guardian has a scout now, but very fine work there from Chris to start things off in the round.
And Nico also getting damaged a little bit, so might want to be careful here. It's one of those situations where you just need to close out the game. There's no point in sort of playing another seven rounds before you finally win it, you know. Just try and see if you can end it quick. And save maybe a little bit of, you know, mental strength for the upcoming Cobblestone map, because that's certainly not going to be easy either. Especially not because I think Na'Vi are going to be real angry about this map.
Well, that's going to be a bit frustrating, Dennis. Now vulnerable on the A side. Rotation has come in from his mate Chris J, who's holding a jungle. Spots out Zeus. Now he knows that there's players pushing from pit as well. So it's all about Dennis just staying alive, and he's doing a magnificent job. Nearly wins the duel versus Flame. He drops him down to 7 HP, but Spitty is there to pick up both kills and a third as well. Spitty shutting Na'Vi out of this, but 16-6 for Mousesports on Mirage versus Na'Vi. Everybody doing work on Mousesports as well. Everybody in the high to mid teens, even the low 20s.
Yeah, Spitty really stepping it up. I mean, that was obviously the 6K that he pulled off in one round. But apart from that, he's been playing way better than he was in the other two games that we've seen from him so far. So definitely.